In this video, we're continuing on with the medians worksheet under the infinite geometry section on the CUDA software website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 7, we need to remember that the median of a triangle connects the vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side. That is a median. The point in which all medians intersect is known as the centroid. And according to the centroid theorem, the centroid is located 2/3 of the way from the vertex to the opposite midpoint. So this would be 2/3 of AU, and GU would be 1/3 of AU. So knowing that, let's get started with number 7. We have to find BG, given that BV, the total length of the median, is 3.9. BG is 2/3. Since B is the vertex, and the centroid is located 2/3 of the way from the vertex to the opposite midpoint. So BG equals 2/3 of the distance of B to V, which is 3.9. So BG equals 2/3 of 3.9. And when we multiply 2/3 times 3.9, we'll get 2.6. So BG equals 2.6 for number 7. In number 8, we're finding EZ. That's the distance from the vertex to the centroid, given that ZV, the distance from the centroid to the opposite midpoint, is 12. So there are two ways we can go about solving this problem. We can calculate the total distance of E to V and then subtract 12 to get E to Z, Or we could calculate the length of EV and then use our equation knowing that EZ is 2/3 of that length. Let's go ahead and use the first method I talked about. So we're finding EZ if ZV is 12. So we know that 12 is 1/3 of EV. So ZV is equal to 1/3 of the total length from E to V. So 12 equals 1/3 of EV. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 3 to get that EV, the entire length of that median, is 36. Now, knowing that E to V is 36, I will subtract 12 from 36 to get EZ. So EZ equals EV minus ZV. So EZ is equal to 36, which is EV, minus 12, which is ZV. So EZ is equal to 24. So 24 is our solution in number 8. In number 9, I have to find DH, given that BH, the entire length of our median, is 4.5. D to H is 1/3 of the distance of B to H. So I can say that DH equals 1/3 of BH, and we're given BH, so DH equals 1/3 of 4.5. 1/3 times 4.5 equals 1.5. So DH equals 1.5 in number 9. In number 10, I'm finding C to G, given that K to G is 41.4. So K to C is 2/3 the distance from K to G. So C to G will be 1/3 of the distance from K to G. So CG equals 1/3 of the distance from K to G. CG equals 1/3 of 41.4. So CG is going to equal 1/3 times 41.4, which is 13.8. So 13.8 is my solution in number 10. In number 11, I'm asked to find x if GE equals 3x plus 5. So G to E, the entire length of this side, is 3x plus 5. And I know that IE, x plus 6, is congruent to IG, since I is the midpoint from E to G, because FI is that median. So I know that IE plus IG is equal to GE. However, since IE is congruent to IG, I can say that IG is also equal to X plus 6. So I can plug X plus 6 in for IE, X plus 6 in for IG, and that's equal to GE, which is 3X plus 5. Now I'm going to combine my like terms and solve for X. X can be combined with X, and 6 can be combined with 6. X plus X is 2X plus 6 plus 6 is 12. So 2X plus 12 equals 3X plus 5. Next, I'll subtract 2X from both sides. And at the same time, since 2X minus 2X gives me 0, I'll subtract 5 from both sides so that 5 minus 5 will also give me 0. So I have 12 minus 5, which equals 7, and that's equal to 3X minus 2X, which is X. So 7 is equal to X in number 11. And lastly in this video, I'll complete number 12. However, before I go over the answer to this, if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below, and remember to click that subscribe button. Number 12 says to find X if TP equals 2X plus 1 and TQ equals 3X minus 5. Well, we know since T is on a median that T is the midpoint of QP. So that means that TQ is congruent to TP. So if TQ is congruent to TP, then TQ is equal to TP. So TQ, 3x minus 5, equals TP, 2x plus 1. I'll subtract 2x from both sides, moving my terms with x to the left, give me that x minus 5 equals 2x minus 2x, which is 0, plus 1, which is 1. Then I'll add 5 to both sides to get that x is equal to 6. So 6 is my solution in number 12. And with that, I wrap up this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out the worksheet completing numbers 13 through 18. And by the conclusion of the next video, we'll finish the medians worksheet. Again, click that subscribe button and don't forget to give me a thumbs up.